next guest has almost 30 years in the construction and support service industries, and he's here today as Global Health and Safety Director at Ferrovial. Ferrovial is a good friend, a partner from South Summit, and as you know, a world-leading infrastructure operator. His main goal is to develop strategic approaches to health and safety that support businesses and people in creating safer workplaces for everyone, every day. Let's welcome Ben Legg. Benjamin, Ben, how are you?
I'm fantastic. Thanks for having me. I hope you're having a great day.
Great. Well, we're enjoying ourselves. We would like to have you here in person. Ben, I'm calling you Ben because I saw in your profile, you Benjamin. No, it's Ben, isn't it?
Yeah, no, you can call me Benjamin or Ben.
Ben, let me ask you a question regarding in your experience, obviously, in health and safety in a company such as Ferrovial. How important is health and safety at workplaces and how innovation can help to keep improving things in this matter?
So, I think I've been listening to some of the previous guys that you've had on, and they've touched on a few things that I think are incredibly important. And, for me, health and safety sometimes in society can conjure up some negativity. They might think about, accidents, incidents, blockages in production. But for me, it's 100% positive. I think about health and safety in an organization as a way of creating the overall culture, how it manages risk, how it operates, the way it integrates with society, how it influences its stakeholders, and ultimately how its employees can exist and create something really special from a day-to-day basis. So I think, health and safety for me in a company really is the heartbeat of how it is, whether it's someone looking in and as an investor or somebody as a potential employee operating within it. From an innovation point of view, I think health and safety over the years has improved, but we're missing a link. And I think the last 10 years, we've really started to see how innovation and technology can support that step change. So, if you think we're just going to work the same way, well, don't expect any different result, and we will continue to harm people in an industry all over the world. If you start to then look at health and safety, recently I've mentioned Boeing 737 MAX, Deepwater Horizon, very mature, big industries, big businesses, but can be better. So, if you really want to start to see success at the next level, I think you have to integrate health and safety. And from an innovation point of view, I think it can impact on three levels. One, around engaging with employees, trying to provide that frictionless environment where people can exist and interact with each other in a very productive way. In systems, I think lots of businesses, probably people on these calls and at this event, their businesses have management systems. But how do you use them? Do they actually add value, or are they there to get some certificate at the end of the day? So using innovation or using technology to create that much improved interface between the person and the process, I think is another area. And education. I think the professor before talked about, the liquid education. For me, the days of teaching people health and safety in a very sort of restricted environment is changing. How you can introduce people using immersive technology into high-risk environments can actually create better places of work and reduce risk when the task actually has to be done. Okay. All the way through to, thinking about individuals and how they can build their own personal reputations around health and safety. We don't have a LinkedIn for blue collar workers, so maybe the time is that we use technology for these guys to build their personal health and safety reputation.
Ben, I think I'm afraid we've run out of time, but thank you for that perspective you gave us. And obviously, your job is health and safety has to always be there, even if we don't see it. The innovation is always behind. So in a way, you're always there, despite some people not realizing. Yeah. So thank you so much for the job you're doing at Ferrovial and showing us what needs to be done to include innovation in health and safety as well. Big kiss to you, Ben. Thank you for coming, and to Ferrovial again, who is helping us throughout all South Summit 2020.